Your Excellency, Mr. President, Honorable Governor, very, very dear old friend of Tibet, Mr. Bruno Milano, and other distinguished guests who are sitting on the dais, and my dear friends. I'm very happy to be here today, and that too on a very important day, as you observe the Liberation Day of your country. As you understand and as you know, we are fighting for freedom at the moment. As I have come to you, this is my second time to Sicily, I have come to you at a very difficult time in my country. I imagine myself to be a mother whose house is burning, and the mother coming out shouting to the neighbors for help. And indeed, when I see doors and windows open of the neighbors, people coming forward to help, it gives a lot of hope and inspiration. So thank you very much for your presence here today. Justice for pro-truth and pro-Tibet friends, and I would like to make a special mention of our Italian sister, we jokingly always tell to Spinoza. Because of their efforts, I was able to leave New Delhi to come to Italy on the 21st of this month. And as I left Delhi, I had two main aim or object in mind when I left Delhi. One was to reach out to the people of Italy as much as possible and to represent my people and carry to you our story. That was my one important mission. And the second was that in 2000, in the year 2000, the European Parliament passed a resolution. It was on the 6th of July 2000, they passed a resolution which said that and encouraged dialogue between Beijing and the Tibetan people, between the Chinese and the Tibetan people. And of course, maybe Mr. Bruno Milano did talk in relation to those events, because he was very, very active at that time and in fact had great contribution. The resolution said that if Tibet and China was not able to come with a solution, political solution through dialogue for 2 years, then they will consider asking their member nations to recognize the Tibetan government as the legitimate representative of the Tibetan people. Contact was established between China and Tibet, but nothing concrete has come so forth. And on top of that, the human condition inside Tibet continues to worsen. Today, the entire country of Tibet is under great tense, under great military surveillance. There's great presence of military in every small villages. Every Tibetan is being watched, being looked at, and we do not today enjoy the basic human rights. On 8th of April 2009, four Tibetans have been given death sentence by the Lhasa court. And all these four people are people who have participated in the peaceful demonstration in March 2008. As I left New Delhi, as I mentioned to you earlier on the 21st, One major task was to appeal to independent individuals, NGOs, local governments to help save the life of these poor people who actually were given court sentences without due process of law. But however, today, while on the flight coming from Torino to Palermo on your iPhone, I read what we were fearing for some time. That is yet another capital punishment, this time to a woman, a very young woman. The charges against her for having participated in the demonstration and for having set fire to some shops, having caused damage to public property. These are the reasons which is quoted, which is mentioned for her getting the capital punishment. So, as I speak with you here today, as I stand before you, I cannot help but remember all those more than 5,000 Tibetan people who since just last year, March 2008, has been arrested. In many cases, it is for distributing pro-freedom pamphlets, or sometimes simply coming out to cheer the pro-democracy demonstrators. And Mr. President, I'm very grateful to you. I heard before we arrived here that His Excellency the President was kind enough to offer his solidarity and condolence with all these people against whom violation of human rights continues. So thank you very much, Your Excellency, for that. Yes. And I would like to say that we Tibetans today, as a nation, as a people, we are going through great sufferings, but we still believe in peace, we believe in non-violence, and we want happiness as any other human being wants happiness. We believe in dialogue, and we need your support to find this happiness in our country. So thank you very much.